Hi, Emma Mattison here, and today we're diving into the science behind muscle cramping and why exactly they happen. Now, before we dive in, I find it imperative to explain that not all muscle discomfort is cramping. A lot of my personal clients, as well as patients of physical therapists and doctors, sometimes can confuse us with the fact that they call what they're experiencing a cramp, when it's not actually a cramp. It's important to differentiate between muscle cramping, spasms, and muscle stiffness, and also muscle soreness, which I will briefly cover, but it is not one of these three. True cramps involve sudden, often painful tightening. Spasming, however, can be much less intense. Muscle stiffness occurs often in cold climates or when the body's not quite warmed up or alongside certain medical conditions. Let me go ahead and use metaphors to help you understand the differences in the feelings between cramps, spasms, and stiffness. Imagine a cramp almost as if somebody's reaching out and grabbing your muscle, holding on tightly, sharply, and not letting go. This will cause pain. It's sudden and it's intense. Now think of a spasm as a rubber band that is spontaneously and involuntarily being stretched and relaxed. Spasming is less about pain and more about involuntary contraction and relaxation of the muscles. Now imagine muscle stiffness like a stiff rope, almost like it's dry rotted. The rope has lost all its flexibility, its ability to bend and take shape. It's just stiff. The stiffness is not necessarily painful, but it'll make you feel more tight and restricted. It's common for a lot of people to feel stiff when they wake up in the morning. All right, now let's clarify the difference between muscle stiffness and muscle soreness, because they're not the same thing. Soreness is not stiffness. Soreness is not cramping. It is also not spasming. So let's clarify that. Muscle soreness, often referred to as delayed onset muscle soreness, is a degree of pain or discomfort that your body feels after intense or new exercise that it's not familiar with. Soreness is a sign that your muscles are recovering and adapting, meaning that they are changing for you. However, it is important to note that you should never be so sore that you are functionally compromised. That means that you are trying to progress way too quickly. So it's important to clarify that some people characterize muscle soreness as a degree of pain. However, they usually characterize it lower on the pain scale. And it's much more the feeling of just an overall achiness to the muscle. However, for all my clients and anyone that I recommend for their training, you should only ever be about slightly sore, and it should never cause you to feel functionally compromised. All right, so now you understand muscle soreness as a result of a training program is not the same as cramping, stiffness, or spasming. All right, now let's get into why these cramps are happening. To understand cramps, it's important to know about our muscles. When muscles contract, they're responding to signals from what are called motor neurons, which basically help as a pathway from communicating from our brain to our muscles. Problems along the way interfering with the correct signaling can cause cramping. It's important to note that this video is for educational purposes only, and there are a lot of different reasons behind cramping. I'm just going to help clarify the most common. So in the process of our brain telling our muscles, hey, contract, these neurons that are working as the in-between messengers need to convey chemicals to get the muscle to respond. Some of these important chemicals I'm going to clarify now. One is called ATP, adenosine triphosphate, and the others are actually just electrolytes. Electrolytes, if you think of the word, sounds like the word electricity, which is exactly the connection happening from our neurons to our muscles. The electrolytes are almost like the electrical current running in our body. The brain stimulates an electrical impulse that must be transferred to the muscle. And the perfect medium to do this is through the usage of the electrolytes in conjunction with the actual neurons. All right, now let's talk about the role of electrolytes and ATP in muscle health. Electrolytes include components you've probably heard of, such as potassium, calcium, magnesium, as well as sodium, which are all crucial for the process of muscle contractions and relaxations. Electrolytes not only help transmit the nerve signals, but they also help to maintain fluid balance within the muscles and within our entire body. If you think about it, that's why water is so important for hydration in our body. It's because the electrical impulse needs to be conducted through something. And that's why you don't go swimming when there's a thunderstorm. Let me give you one more example of how the electrolytes work. Let's just take calcium and magnesium as an example. Calcium is responsible for assisting in the actual muscle contractions, and magnesium is responsible for inhibiting some proteins that cause the muscles to stay contracted. In other words, magnesium helps with relaxation, calcium helps with contraction. They're both crucial and need to be in the proper balance. For this reason, an imbalance in electrolytes can definitely lead to cramps and spasms. Now, how does ATP or adenosine triphosphate come into all this? ATP, if you get rid of the crazy name behind it, ATP is just the energy currency of our cells. Every time we move for both contraction and relaxation, ATP is necessary for facilitating the power and the actual movement itself. When you're exercising or even just moving about daily life, your muscles are contracting and relaxing repeatedly. And I will say it's a very complex pathway behind who inhibits who and who will promote who. So I'm just giving you the basic overview. I can go in much greater detail in another video, but I'm not entirely sure that my audience would want that. So if you do want that, comment in this video and prove me wrong. For both of these actions, contracting and relaxing, your muscles need energy. And that's where ATP comes in. If, for example, you've done a really intense bout of movement or exercise that your body has not yet become accustomed to, the muscle itself can run out of currency, or ATP. Now it doesn't have enough energy to facilitate the relaxation of the muscles themselves. This, in turn, can lead to that cramping. As you know by now, several factors can trigger cramping. These include exercise intensity, or rather duration or intensity of exercise that your particular body is not yet acclimated to, dehydration, which can be caused by an electrolyte imbalance, or cramping can even be brought on by certain medications, as well as underlying conditions. All right, now let's talk about treatment of cramps, so how to deal with them, and prevention. To alleviate a cramp, stop the exercise you're doing and gently massage the muscle, relax, breathe, and gently stretch it. To prevent cramping, it's important to maintain a balanced diet rich in minerals, the right amount of electrolytes, and to stay hydrated. To support healthy muscle function, consider including foods rich in electrolytes. These include avocados, leafy greens, nuts, seeds. And notice I didn't mention bananas. Bananas are okay, but the amount of bananas that you would need to eat to get the potassium that you need may offset your blood sugar too much. Bananas are pretty high in sugar. In some cases, supplements may be necessary to obtain the proper levels of these minerals and electrolytes in your diet, especially if you have dietary restrictions or you're a particularly active individual who sweats a lot. Now, I will also add a side note that it is very easy for us to consume way too much sodium in our society, and then correspondingly, we end up with a massive potassium imbalance that works hand in hand with sodium. I have an entire video on that whole subject, so check that one out so that you can learn more about the electrolyte imbalance your body needs. Now, of course, I need to leave you with this. If cramping is frequent, very painful, or ever accompanied by swelling or skin changes, then it's time to consult a healthcare professional. As I stated before, cramping can sometimes indicate an underlying medical cause, such as atherosclerosis, as just one example, which for those of you wondering, is a condition that relates to your heart health. So just another reason why to exercise for a healthy heart. So remember, if you're feeling these warning signs where this cramping is a bit too much, talk to a doctor. All right, so now you understand the differences between the lingo, which is extremely helpful to understand. So that way, when you're going to your doctor or physical therapist, or you're working with me, your trainer, you're able to tell me exactly what you're feeling, where the pain or the cramping is felt, and if it's actually a cramp, or if it's a spasm, stiffness, or just muscle soreness. I hope this video has been enlightening and you know even more about how your fantastic body functions for you all the time, without it ever asking anything of you in return. If you've enjoyed this video, hit the like, share it to whoever may benefit, and always remember, your health is an investment, not an expense.